we're gonna do the title track off of this new album. And this is the Major League Blues, not baseball. A lot of people confuse me with a Cleveland baseball player by the name of Jose Ramirez. Funny story, me and Charles played a show in Cleveland, right downtown, little pub, little bar, right next to the stadium, and that night, the team was playing.
I know where you at.
Yeah, what was the name of that? Wilbert's? Or?
Yeah,
Wilbert's. Yeah, Wilbert's Barbecue. It's closed, no longer there, one of the COVID victims, unfortunately. Yeah, man, but we were playing the show, and then all these people started just coming in, and the place was packed, and people went there after the baseball game, and they were all wearing their baseball jerseys, you know. And each one of the people that came through that door had a jersey that said Jose Ramirez.
Yeah.
So I'm like, hell yeah, we're gonna make it. It's gonna be, we're almost there.
He's the most MVP of their team.
Yeah, man. So famous Jose Ramirez, and because of that and other confusions in the past, we decided to call this album, or title this album, the Major League Blues. And this is the story.
Thank you.
play the blues just by listening to the records. The first guy I listened to stole my heart still today. Number one blues guitar teacher, B.B. King.
Yeah.
If he was still with us, he would sound a little bit like this. Quite important. Oh, there goes the tie with Pedro the Roach down there. Thank you, brother. There was another guitar player that was very influential. There's a guy by the name of Albert Collins.
Yeah!
If he was still with us, I want to believe he would sound a little bit like this with a similar guitar. Charles have had the opportunity to be joined by on stage when we play in Chicago. And you cannot avoid this guy's legacy.
Legends, baby.
Mr. Buddy Guy.
Yeah!
He's still with us, so yeah. I hope I pay him a good treat for you. We'll be right back. Tincho, what you got?